Today, in this video, we are going to explore the latest UiPath product updates. Hi everyone, welcome back to the next video on the UiPath product update series, where we try to explore the updates which happen in the UiPath product. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am now a 5-time UiPath MVP, certified solution architect and a LinkedIn top voice. I have shared my LinkedIn details on the page. Feel free to send a connection request. Happy to be part of your network. Also, you see a QR code on the screen which you can scan and join our WhatsApp community, where we have a lot of other developers. So at any point of time, you have any doubts, question, feel free to post it and the fellow developers help. Also, whenever there is a video getting uploaded, you get a direct notification on your channel. So with that, let's get started. So I am into my UiPath Studio. I am recording this video in the month of June 2025. And this is how my UiPath Studio look like. Okay. So first thing first, you would notice that the design is very minimal and the upper ribbon is collapsed, right? However, you always has an option here to you can expand it and you can go back to the previous old layout. However, if you want to have more space while designing the automation, you can go here and you can collapse this as well. Okay. The other thing you would notice here that whenever you are looking at the bottom of the screen, right, we used to have a lot of panels. They are still here, which is like the error list, the output, the breakpoint panel, all of that is available, but they are now docked for a much more cleaner view, right? So if you see at the bottom, this is where the error list and everything is happening. This is the symbol which is for the output. You click on that and you get the output screen, right, which you have all the different things from debug, from compile, which output you want to see, that is available here. And then you have the breakpoints panel as well, that in case you have any breakpoints or anything. Okay. Now, let's try to go to activities, right? This where you would notice a significant change. Previously, all these tabs were in a, I would say, vertical, and now they are in a horizontal layout, right? So project is here, and just after that you have activities, object repository and snippets, right? So for example, today I want to create some automation, so I'll go to the activities and let's try to just maybe drag and drop some activity like this. Okay, and now for this activity, the property is again, previously in the older version, the property was written here and you have to click on that. So now I can just click on this one, which is the outline of the structure, just above it, this setting kind of, I would say, I don't know what this icon is called, but this is for the properties, right? So you have an option to pin this and then the next icon is the autopilot and then you have the outline, right? So I prefer to do it like this because I can just go here and click on this property here, right? So this update is called the panel docking. I personally like this clean space. Let me know in the comments if you like the panel docking. Maybe just comment down panel docking. So I understand that you also like this clean approach. Okay, let's move to the next one. The next update which you will see is in the data manager panel. So previously, whenever as a developer I used to create variables and arguments, I have two ways of doing it. Either I used to have the variables argument tabs here, and in the updated design, UiPath had something which is called the data manager panel. Now with this latest update, you would see that the data manager panel is missing from this right hand side, and data manager panel is available at the bottom hand side, at the bottom left of the screen, which is the first icon, which is this briefcase kind of icon. So you click on that and that is where the data managers lie. So data manager is a place. Now here, this is kind of a tabular thing where you can manage all your variables, arguments, namespaces, connections, everything at a single place. At any point of time, if you want to create a new variable, you can just go to the variable panel. Here you have something which is called create a variable, and then you have an option to just use it as per your requirement. Okay, now for arguments, the similar concepts, you can just go here and keep continuing creating the argument. Into one of the previous update video, we have seen that UiPath has also got a concept of global variable and constants. And now if you notice here with this new updates, I do not see an option to create global variables. Is it not no longer available? It's not the case, right? So to create global variables, you just have to right click on this variable, right? Not here, but you can just click on wherever it says the variable, right click on it, and there you see something which is called new global variable and the new constant, right? So I can just go here and I can say new global variable. I'll say GV global variable, make it a string, and I'll say okay, and you can see that the global variable is now created, right? We have already explored this global variable and constant in the previous video, so I'll hook up it in the description. Feel free to refer that to understand the concept. Okay, so now with this, the data manager panel is here. You can create arguments, namespace, connections, everything, and you can minimize it, right? How cool is that? I like this feature where I could see everything in a tabular format. Let me know, what do you think? If you like this feature, maybe just comment down data manager, right? So I understand that we both are on the same page. Okay, so the next update is towards the scope of the variables, right? So in one of the previous update, again the same concept, right? We had a way to see the scope of the variables. What do I mean by that and what is the change? Let's try to find it out. Okay, so for example, I am a developer and writing an automation. Okay, and you can see that this left menu is also collapsed, right? So I'll go to the activities, I'll create a sequence, right? So for example, I am writing an automation and this is my main sequence. Okay, inside that main sequence, let me just go here and create one more other sequence which is kind of a child, and I call this sequence as A, and then I will create one more sequence inside the main and I'll call this sequence as B. Okay, so I have one main sequence called the parent, which is main, and then I have A and then I have B. Okay, now let's go to the B, right, which is this inner sequence, and I'll go and I'll create a new variable. I'll call this as variable B, and the scope of the variable is set to B, right? So whichever scope you will select here, and then you go to the variable panel and you create a variable, you would see that the scope of the variable is coming to that, right? And then if I click on the main and I try to click a new variable, then this would be for the variable main, right? Now at any point of time, if I only want to see the variable who has scope of only B, I can just go to the variable panel, and this is where the scope, active scope, was available. Previously this was also part of the data manager, which was in the right hand side. Now with this change, this is also available here into this one, which is the scope. So if I just go to the scope and I click on these buttons, you would notice that now it is only showing me the variables which has access to this one, which is like this variable, this variable. Now if I click on A and go to the variables, you would see that it is only showing me the variables which are accessible in the A. It is not showing the variables of the B. At any point of time, if I want to see every variable, all the variables, you can click, toggle this off, and you would see all the variables, right? So which means that whenever you are working as a developer and you want to see that which all variables you have access into that sequence, you can just go here and go to this and click on this guy, which is the active scope, and now you know that which variables are restricted to which scope, right? This was also already there, but with this new update, it is now part of this data manager panel, right? Let me know your thoughts by just commenting maybe active scope in the comments, so that I understand you like this feature. Okay, and now let's move to the next one. Now the next one is, if you go to the top in the design, you would see that now you have an option here which is called the new long running workflow, right? Which means that if now I have a long running workflow which we create mostly whenever we are working with an agentic flow, all those agentic flow can be now part of your RPA process, right? And this is now where the long running workflow will be there, and this is now kind of a canvas where you can design your long running workflow. How cool is that, right? Now one more thing, if you notice here that we have this icon here which is called the autopilot, right? Now autopilot is part of the UiPath product. We have a full-fledged playlist which is completely created on autopilot for everyone. So I hope you guys already have knowledge of autopilot for everyone. In case the answer is no, feel free to refer to the playlist. However, autopilot is now part of your UiPath Studio as well, which can help you with a lot of different stuff. So for example, I am in this automation and let's try to go and maybe put this item here, and this has now an error, right? So if I go to the autopilot now, and you can see here it says that two issues identified with the correct current workflow, which is this. So I can just say get me the suggestions, and based on my errors, based on my state of the project, I am going to get some of the suggestions from autopilot. I can say apply, and it will just try to fix my collection. How cool is that, right? So autopilot is the AI feature which is now available into majority of the products of UiPath. So make sure that you take full advantage of this thing, right? Do you like this? Yes, it fixed my problem, right? So the more about this you would find into this UiPath forum thread. You can just go to forum.uipath.com and you would see here the 2025 community May release, right? I would highly recommend all the developers to be part of the UiPath forum and just keep yourself updated with this fast changing product, right? So with that, I would like to wrap this video here. I hope you find this video insightful. Any more questions, any more doubts, feel free to write me in the comments, or you can also drop me an email as well, right? So wrapping this video here, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please do subscribe to the channel, and happy automation.